On, hold on. This was an amazing birthday surprise, so thank you so much. Hello everyone and welcome back to Do Musafir. You are watching Italy travel series and today is day 2 in Rome.
In case you have watched our previous vlog, you know that today is 6th of June and today is Hero's birthday. Somebody has turned wiser and older.
I don't know about wiser, but definitely older.
So today's day is going to be super amazing because we are going to explore some beautiful, amazing places in Rome that are a must visit. So let's get exploring.
Yay! Our first spot for today is
the Grand Colosseum.
It is one of the 7 wonders of the world.
And can you imagine, it is 2000 years old.
The public transportation in Italy is excellent. To reach the Colosseum, we took a metro to the Colosseo metro station and it opened right in front of this ancient wonder. The metro is always jam-packed since it's a very popular spot, so please be cautious of your personal belongings. We pre-booked a group guided tour because honestly I wanted to know all about this monument which I had only seen in my history books. After brief information on the do's and the don'ts, we started our tour. Right next to the Colosseum are the two other historically important structures and our tour covered all three. Our first stop was Roman Forum. While everything was in ruins, we got to know from our guide that for centuries, the Roman Forum was the center of the day-to-day life in Rome, the site of triumphal processions and elections, the venue for public speeches, criminal trials and gladiatorial matches. This place has been called the most celebrated meeting place in the world in all of history. It is a rectangular forum surrounded by the ruins of several important ancient government buildings at the center of the city of Rome. From there, we climbed the Palatine Hill, which has been called the first nucleus of the Roman Empire.
At the top of the Palatine Hill,
and it gives a beautiful balcony view overlooking the Roman Forum,
the temples and other Roman ruins.
The Palatine is the most famous of Rome's 7 hills. In ancient Rome, this was one of the most desired neighborhoods and was the home of all the big aristocrats and emperors. Apart from a lot of ruins of shrines, this green heaven is covered with gardens, umbrella-shaped pine trees, palaces and amphitheaters, which honestly are very beautiful. But now, it's time to visit the next door neighbor, Colosseum. There is always a huge line to enter the Colosseum, but thanks to our guided tour, we got skipped the line access to the iconic monument. It is the largest ancient amphitheater ever built. Our guide told us stories of the glorious battles that were fought among the gladiators here. It was also used for public spectacles including animal hunts, executions, reenactments of the famous battles and dramas based on Roman mythology. We even went to the lower level and saw the ruins up close.
Hey guys, we have just completed our guided tour. It was around 3 hours long.
And we visited the Palatine Hill, the Roman Forum, and finally ended it at the Grand Colosseum.
Yay!
But now we are super hungry, and before we begin the rest of the exploration, I think we are going to grab something to eat.
We saw the Colosseum for one last time and started walking towards our lunch. We came to La Prezzemolina, which is an easygoing counter-serve outpost serving authentic Italian pizza with varied toppings, salads and sandwiches. since this was our first meal of the day, so we ordered like crazy, and man, the food was fabulous. Our next destination was a little far, so we took the bus. Oh, by the way, if you're watching this video, don't forget to like it as well.
So we are at our next destination, and that is the Mouth of Truth.
It is famously said that it will bite off the hand of any liar that puts his hand in the mouth. Let's see what the legend is.
Well, luckily the Mouth of Truth was kind to Archit. Now on to our next destination.
If you are ever in Rome, you are bound to get tired because of so much walking.
That is why we recommend you to come to the banks of River Tiber. It is extremely beautiful and mesmerizing, and you simply want to relax and grab a cold drink.
Come, let's go back to the hotel. Super tired.
Hello people. Since we were super tired, we directly came back to the hotel, took a power nap, a small shower, and now we are all ready to head out for the birthday dinner. But before that, I thought, you know, since it's Archit's birthday, so I should plan a small surprise for him. He was there with me for the entire day, so he knows that I've bought a small pastry sort of cake for him. But then he does not know that I've planned a little surprise for him, and I'll show you what I did.
We went to Luciano's Roma, which is an Argentina-based chain of gelato shops located just 100 meters from Trevi Fountain. Besides having some really yummy mini cakes, this place had the coolest looking gelatos based on different Roman monuments. So Archit chose what he wanted, and then we left for the hotel. This is how the room was decorated for my boy's birthday.
I hope you liked it, and I hope he likes it, because it is for him. So I think he's waiting for me outside. So let's quickly grab my stuff and we'll head out. I don't want him to enter the room. So let's go.
Hey guys, so we are here finally for the dinner. We have a waiting, and the line that you are seeing behind me, this is the waiting line, and we have to wait about 35-40 minutes. This is the place behind me, and it has over 34,000 reviews, so that is why we had chosen this place for the birthday dinner.
Located in the Trastevere district, Tonarello is right in the thick of it all. This restaurant is popular and had quite the line. We quickly queued up, which was probably smart because the line gets significantly busier around the mealtime. Tonarella has insane amount of seating for the restaurant, both indoor and outdoor. The moment we sat down to enjoy our meal, we understood the hype around here. It serves true, good, authentic Italian food. We ordered 4 cheese flatbread pizza, pasta cappuccia, and focaccia for our dinner.
So after the lovely, lovely birthday dinner, it's time for some gelato at Martinucci.
His smile melted my heart, and I was so happy to make him happy on his special day.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Alright guys, this is it for this video. We'll see.
Hold on. This was an amazing birthday surprise, so thank you so much.
You're welcome. So tomorrow we have a very busy day, and we are super tired today. So we are going to end this video, but stay tuned to our vlogs, our Rome series, because tomorrow we are going to explore the beautiful city of Vatican and Pantheon. Till then, stay tuned.
So we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Take care.